closest, and now we are learning one of the most expensive congressional campaigns in California history. Voters cast their ballots Tuesday in Ventura County's 26th congressional district battle between Julia Brownlee and Jeff Gorrell. But as News Channel 3's Kelsey Gerkins tells us, that race is far from over tonight. She joins us live in Ventura with more on that. Kelsey.
CJ, right now, Julia Brownlee holds a meager 530-vote lead over Republican Jeff Gorrell. But with 53,000 ballots yet to be counted, the race could still go anyway. Ventura County's competitive 26th congressional district did not disappoint. The toss-up race is expected to remain undecided for weeks to come.
We knew it was going to be close from the very beginning.
It's been a long journey. Ironically, I got in a year ago into the race, and they said I got in late.
The fierce campaign had Republican Jeff Gorrell, a sitting member of the Assembly and Afghanistan war veteran, fighting to take the seat away from Democrat Julia Brownlee, a freshman House member who 2 years ago became the first Democrat in 70 years to be elected to represent Ventura County in Congress. The campaigning for the congressional seat was intense. The Democrats brought in former President Bill Clinton just days before the election to stump for votes in Oxnard for Brownlee, while Republicans brought in House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy for Gorrell.
Elect Jeff Gorrell.
The hot race was also pricey, with the candidates breaking records for spending in a county political campaign. The candidates and outside groups spent more than $7.7 million on this race. The financial resources were 2-1 in Brownlee's favor.
Julia Brownlee.
As the battle comes to an end, both candidates say they are happy with the way they ran their campaign.
I think I ran a positive campaign, and it's a little bit of an experiment to see if somebody who's running a positive campaign can actually win.
We had just armies and armies of volunteers, and I think their effort and their work is really what's going to make the difference. So I am extremely grateful and a very lucky candidate.
State election law says that results must be finalized by the beginning of December, and this race is so close, it probably will be close to December before we have the final outcome. But tomorrow, we'll get updated results from the Ventura County Clerk and Recorder's Office, and I'll be sure to pass those along to you. Reporting live in Ventura, Kelsey Gerkins, News Channel 3.
All right, thank you, Kelsey. About 53,000 ballots have yet to be added to Ventura County's results. 43,000 of those are vote-by-mail ballots. They were either late arrivals to the post office on Election Day or were dropped off at county elections office or polling places on Election Day. The remaining 9,500 ballots yet to be counted are provisional ballots cast by poll voters who, for whatever reason, were not listed on the roster at their polling place.
In the 24th Congressional